What is going on, guys? Joey Franzel here with Flex Training Systems. It is Monday, the Monday of Thanksgiving. I'm not really too sure what the date is, even though I've been riding it all day. Was it the 20th? I think it's the 20th. How are you guys doing? Feeling very thankful. I'm thankful all the time, but I'm extra thankful during Thanksgiving week. On my way to the gym right now. Sipping on PR Breaker. Shout out to Derek. I'm not even going to try to say your last name. I think it's French-Canadian. For sending this to me, as well as giving me samples at Nationals. I really enjoy this pre-workout. It's becoming something I look forward to taking every day. Full review coming later. Today, I wanted to talk about or answer a question. It wasn't really a question, but it was a suggestion made by one of my clients. Shout out to Simon Chang. He said, "Hey Joey, some of my CPU boys be on that Smolov tip. I was wondering if you could make a video, you know, talking about why you should or shouldn't run it." And this is just a topic that keeps coming up all the time, and I'm surprised I haven't covered it sooner. But for those of you that don't know, Smolov is a very squat-intensive training program. There's also one for bench. I think you run squat and bench concurrently. There is no deadlifting, although there may be some user-created versions that may have deadlifting in it. So, if you want the quick answer as to why you probably shouldn't run Smolov, the answer is because you can make very good progress doing not nearly as much. If you want the long answer, well, that's this entire video. Typically, guys see Smolov, like if you look at like a forum or something and some guy will say, "I ran Smolov, I put 50 pounds on my squat, these are my numbers." When you look at that, it seems very tempting, and it can almost come across as a quick fix. Now, I believe that those people are putting 50 pounds on their squat in X amount of time or however long they choose to run the program. I'm not sure. I know there's multiple different versions. I think there's one that's 4 weeks, 8, 12, whatever. It's a very, it's basically putting your body in a state of, "Oh my God, I'm gonna die. I need to adapt to this stimulus that I'm receiving quicker, than I'm used to." So what happens is, you adapt and you're either gonna get hurt or you're gonna get really strong. Not really strong, but you're gonna get stronger than where you were, right? Everything is relative. The problem is, let's say you somehow get through the entire thing injury-free. You don't get a single injury, you don't get hurt at all. One, that's very impressive. You must really take care of yourself, or you must have just tendons made of steel. And you must have the best form in the world. So you finish the program, you make all these gains, right? You put 50 pounds on your squat. So you're squatting 500, you run the program, you squat 550, right? That's pretty good, pretty good gains in a short amount of time. The problem is, what do you do now? How do you maintain those gains? You acquired those gains squatting four times a week. Unless you plan on squatting four or three times a week or some modified version, to where you're keeping that stimulus around all the time, it's not going to be sustainable. And I know people, many, many people, there's one on my head, I don't want to put them on blast right now, that they run the program, they try to maintain their frequency, and then they eventually get hurt and they fucking disappear. And then they come back like a year later and they, do something not as aggressive. You learn your lesson, basically. I don't know anyone that runs Smolov all the time, or that it's their bread and butter. I know that Ben Rice, who I just did the podcast with, actually did a while ago, it just took forever to get up. I know he ran it a couple times, but then, it wasn't sustainable, and now he does something different. He can probably still tolerate a good amount of volume, But it's just not sustainable. So you'll make these gains and then you can't maintain them. There is a huge injury factor. You know, the injury rate, the chances of you getting hurt are very high. Like, I think it's like 50% of people that actually run the program and complete the entire thing, potentially more actually get hurt. I don't know. I know more people, way more people that have tried it than have completed it. And that should be telling you something right there. You know, the program is completely percentage based, and percentages don't take into account, you know, your what's going on in your life, your daily fluctuations. There's no, as far as I know, there's no auto-regulatory implementation. There's nothing in the program that's like, hey, if you're feeling this way, do X or Y, which, you know, which makes sense. Smolov is very old. There are a lot of things in Smolov and Shiko, right? It's the Shiko training program. That when I look at them, I'm like, this doesn't really make, like, I don't understand. I kind of get what you're trying to do here, but it just kind of seems random. It just seems like a lot. Like, you're just doing a lot of shit. The body will respond to a lot of shit. It absolutely will respond. But again, if you can put 50 pounds in your squat in 8 to 10 weeks, you know, running something crazy, why not just do it in 16 to 20 weeks? Like, not even hurt at all, zero injury. It's all a like, basically you're gonna be, it's a net gain. You're just gaining all that strength. You have no injury, and you're doing it on a frequency that is low enough that allows you to kind of just maintain your lifestyle, right? So squatting once or twice a week, and granted, I do have some people squatting 3-4 times a week. Not everybody needs to do that. Everybody's different. If you're a smaller female lifter, you might be able to get through Smolov. It's gonna get to the point, and this is something that I've heard from every single person that's around the program, to where you do not want to train. You dread going into train because it's gonna hurt. You're already sore and you're achy, and it's not like DOMS. Like, yeah, you'll get that in the beginning, but soon you're just gonna be sore from, like, you know, where your quad attaches to your knee is just beat the fuck up from you squatting so frequently. You know, some of those rep ranges are ridiculous. One of the days on there, I think it's like an 8x6 or something crazy. After like a 4x10, it gets absurd. It gets absurd, absurd, absurd. And even with lightweight overtime, that's going to wear you down. You know, so you don't need to do it. You just simply don't need to do it. You can make great progress not working nearly as hard. There are no shortcuts. You're going to need to put in the work to make the gains. But is it going to be sustainable? Is there going to be a very high injury factor? If you're in a caloric surplus, that's going to help you. But a lot of my lifters that we used higher frequency in the beginning to kind of boost up, you know, let's say they were bulking up, we use it to kind of gain some ground. You know, I've dialed them back and we're able to kind of maintain a high level of performance on not nearly as much frequency. And this is it kind of reminds me of bodybuilders going through a contest diet, where, you know, they come to a coach and they're eating absolutely nothing and they're fat and they're eating way more at the end of it. The body reacts to stimulus, whether that's food, whether that's training, whether that's stress, you know, it just wants to survive. So if we can, you know, kind of trick the body to do what we want, then you're going to be better off. But it has to be, like I said, it has to be sustainable. I don't care who you are. I promise you, squatting, you know, this is just an exaggeration, but squatting 3x10 on squats every single day is going to break you down mentally and your body down. And, you know, it's like, you get to a point where it's like, you know, do I want to go in today and potentially fuck myself up in hopes to put an extra 10 pounds in my squat in X amount of weeks? You know what I'm saying? So, the pros, you'll get strong quick. You'll get stronger quicker. The cons, high chance of injury. It's not sustainable. Meaning you'll have to maintain that frequency or something very close to it. Or you're just going to lose that progress. It happens all the time. I hear it all the time. Injury, it's not sustainable. It's not practical. So hopefully that gave you guys enough of a reason to not run Smolov. Work your way up. But more likely than not, you're not gonna need to get anywhere near, you know, small levels of volume and training frequency to get those gains. I will say that Smolov Jr. for bench, it's still a lot, but on the bench press, we can tolerate a bit more and, you know, probably get away with it. But again, you probably don't need to be benching four times a week to make progress. Now, again, everything's relative. Some people do, some people don't. You need to, you know, it's a lot of it's trial and error. If you have a coach, listen to your coach, and they can, you know, figure that out for you. That's like one of the main things that I do is trying to figure out, what key fits to the lock, right? Each lifter has a lock, and I have all these keys, and you need to find the right one. And sometimes you need multiple keys for a very sophisticated and complicated lock, if that makes sense. And it might change. Imagine the lock might change. It might be completely different over time. These are things that we need to look out for. But yeah, now we're getting into another topic. I hope you guys are able to take something away from this video. Again, it is Thanksgiving time. I'm gonna try to, get more of these car recordings out. They actually help me a ton because I can save time. I can multitask. I can transport myself to the gym and back from the gym and crank out a video, working and whatnot. We got the holidays coming up. Trying to clear my schedule so I can just have that Thanksgiving day where I just, you know, enjoy the family and the day. And I hope you guys are able to spend some time with your families. Think about everything that you're thankful for. I think we should do it all the time, not just on Thanksgiving. But think about, you know, as miserable as you might be, I've been saying this a lot lately, you're going to be better off than most people. And you're probably a lot better off than where you were before. But yeah. Alrighty, guys. Thank you so much for listening. If you made it this far, let me get a I'm thankful in the comments below. Hashtag I'm thankful. Alrighty, talk to you in the next one. Peace.